What is up, YouTube? My name is Ricky, and today we'll be reacting to Ghost. We're back reacting to Ghost. This one is Watcher in the Sky. That is what we will be reacting to today. I can't words anymore. I completely give up. Per usual, before we get started, like, subscribe, and if there's anything you want me to react to, please let me know in the comments down below. I will try to get to them as fast as possible. I believe this song, Watcher in the Sky, is from their newest album. I think the only song I've heard from them would be 20s. I was pleasantly surprised, and I was surprised. Like, it was not the direction I thought they were gonna go. Kind of threw me off with a little reggaeton feel. So I have no idea what they got in store here, because the couple of songs that I've heard from Ghost have been a very wide variety of influences and genre, like, pieces that they've been taking. So I don't know what I'm in for here for Watcher in the Sky. So let's just get right into it, shall we? It would help if I was on the right screen. Here you go. All right, Watcher in the Sky. First time listen. Let's go. Okay. Okay, so something I am noticing in this particular one. So obviously, again, like I mentioned right at the beginning, they have a lot of different influences that I've noticed from the couple of songs I've heard. This one has a very old school kind of like hair metal feel, almost, with the guitar riffs in particular. A lot of just regular, like, chugging on the same note, and just a little riff at the end of, like, the phrase to give it some texture, to give it some color. I think I mentioned it in the 20s, what do you call it, the 20s reaction, but the drum mastering is way more palatable than the stuff I've heard previously on their older stuff. It could just be that with age, like, the mastering and mixing has gotten better. It's also very possible that that's just not the sound they were going for. I personally like this kind of mastering better. The way that the toms, it's mostly the toms and the bass drum are where I'm noticing it the most, where the mastering is much cleaner would be the sound. It's not as muddy, but it's also having to do with, there's a lot more action. There's a lot more notes that the drummer is playing in this song and in 20s. So that could just be that with this record or this album in general, they wanted, because there's more movement note-wise, that they wanted something a little more crisp. So they didn't want to make the sound like, if you were to say, for instance, like, you hit one bass drum and it has this very long resonating sound and you try to play like a bunch of notes into a small amount of time, it's just going to sound like a wall of noise. And so you can't really hear the clarity of the notes they're trying to hit. This actually reminds me a lot of there must have been another ghost song I've heard, because this sounds similar to another one. I just can't think of it, and I don't know if I've reacted to it, to be honest with you. But the way that the melodies are very... I don't want to use the word simple, but it's very easily listenable. Like, it's a very easy listen for people who maybe have never heard any rock music in general. So it's not overwhelming, and the mastering and his voice in general have something to do with this. So they pick and choose their spots when they want to be more technically sound, but that's not what they're going for. So that I'm very intrigued by this. Also, they used a double bass, a lot of it, in this in the 20s. There's a ton of it there. Good. Nice little dive bomb there from the guitars. Filling the open space. That was a long note he held. Very nice. Ooh, guitar solo. Good harmonies. Very good. Sounded like a different chord. And then fade away. Okay, yeah, so I actually really like this one. The first song that comes to mind when I hear this stylistically sounding, if you have ever heard the song called Round and Round by a band called Rat, I think it's RATT is the That's how you spell that band name. So yeah, if you look up the song Round and Round, that's the first song that comes into my mind when I hear this, stylistically speaking. And it's like, I'm pretty sure it's from like the mid to late 80s. But the way that the song is constructed, so song construction wise, it's your typical what's called an abacab, if you've ever heard of it. So ABA. Oh, no, it's not abacab. What's it? It's AB. Basically, opening riff, verse, chorus, bridge, chorus. So it's a very simplistic, not stereotypical, that's not the word I want to use, but it's like when you're first getting into music writing, this is the most easy to comprehend and least complicated. I don't want to call it simplistic, because sometimes simplicity, you need that in music, especially if it depends on who you're playing the music for. So like for myself, I find myself listening to more technically sounding, more complicated stuff, because it makes my brain think. But also there are some days where you just don't want your brain to work when you're trying to listen to music. You just want to lay back, want to let the music hit you. You want to sing the lyrics as loud as you possibly can. And this, they definitely do that very well. Like the way that they write their lyrics and their melodies makes it so easy for people who go to their concerts to sing along. Like they want it, basically they're the band that's like, I'm gonna start singing this lyric and you're gonna finish it, essentially. And I, more power to them. I like, it's a very it gets the crowd involved. Like there's much more crowd involvement when you do stuff like this. So it's kind of hard, like if you go to a concert that's, for example, if you go to like a concert for Animals as Leaders, if you've ever heard that band, they are some of the greatest musicians I have ever heard. Imagine going to one of their concerts though and trying to dance or sing, or what, actually they don't have any lyrics, at least the earlier stuff that I've heard, but trying to like headbang or anything to get to like vibe along to, like it's physically impossible because they're constantly changing time signatures, and for the average viewer, it turns the average viewer or listener off, because they're just like, I don't actually comprehend what's going on, and it's not worth the effort of trying to figure it out. So I'm not gonna subject myself to trying to figure out how to listen to music. You know, like you listen to music because it channels a feeling maybe you can't portray that someone else is portraying to you, or vice versa. There's a great saying that I think it was done by I think Dave Grohl said it years ago, where it was like, the great thing about music is that you can sing a song to 30,000 people and they'll sing it back to you for 30,000 different reasons. And I think it's so true, because it all depends on the individual, of where you are in your life, like any life events that maybe you're going through, and as the musician as well. So you're just trying to portray whatever you are feeling. And so for bands like Ghost, who keep it more on the simple side in terms of their songwriting, not lyrically, they've got that down, but like in terms of structure, song structure, they make it very palatable for just your normal listener who maybe has never heard them before. So it's a very easy transition into their other stuff. And so I more like all the respect to them, because that can be a very, there's something, the rock metal industry is a very fickle one. Like if you try to do something that isn't as technically sound, then all of a sudden you're not, it's dumb. Like it's like you're not part of the industry, like you don't belong. And it's a very unfortunate truth that it just is what it is. But a Ghost has been doing this for what, 8, 9 years, 10 years, I don't know how long they've been around, and they're still going strong. Look, they're still like putting out like record selling albums. So hey, they're doing something right that the rest of the metal community hasn't figured out. So more power to them, dude. All right, so with that, guys, that's going to do it for the video today. Please remember to like and subscribe, and then comment any suggestions you have for me down below. I think the next video may be maybe Nightwish. Nightwish Army, I have heard you loud and clear. You were very, very supportive of the previous videos, so I think that's going to be coming out next week if you are interested in that. And last but not least, we do usually stream on Twitch 3 days a week. That is still currently on hiatus while I figure out my work schedule. I will let you guys know when that will be back up. And until then, I'll see you guys later. Take care.